Welcome back. Well, to shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to have this phone call, Professor Dr. Gamal Abu Surur, Director of Islamic Center for Population Studies, Al Azhar University. Good afternoon, Dr. Surur.
Good afternoon to you.
Dr. Surur, could you give us an idea about the word that was delivered by Grand Imam of Al Azhar before the conference?
Well, as all of us know, that the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar has been the advocate for this intercultural and inter-religious dialogue. He has been advocating for this with the Holy Pope Francisco of the Vatican, and he held lots of meetings with other religious leaders and different cultures. Of course, this is in international direction all over the world. We have to remember also that the United Nations started this dialogue, intercultural and interreligious dialogue, since the year 2007, where leaders from the various faiths and various cultures, they got together and they discussed the thing. And as the Grand Imam mentioned, that it is important that if we are having this intercultural and interreligious dialogue, we should develop a space for understanding, and we should accommodate to each other, and we should not try to impose believing of someone on the others, but we have to be tolerant and we have to collaborate in all aspects, because certainly there are major points of agreement. There are a few points of disagreement, and this should not prevent us from continuing our collaboration for the benefit of humanity.
Yes.
It's only in this way that we can progress and we can protect the human beings all over, whether they are Muslims, Christians, Jews, non-believers. This is important to have, and it is important to translate what we say in the conference room to reality in life. Rather than just restricting our activities to what is being said in conferences. What is being said in conferences, that's a good point, that's a good start, but let us translate what we have been saying into action.
Yes, Dr. Surur, actually the word and the speech by a Grand Imam of Al-Azhar was a significant one, especially that he mentioned how many times the word peace was mentioned in Quran in comparison to the word war, and
yes.
Peace was, so could you comment on this?
That's right, absolutely, yeah, absolutely. And when, you know, we look thoroughly into the Islamic religion, we find that the Islamic religion is one of the religions which called for peace all the time. And, you know, if war is mentioned, it is for the defense of the country, it is for the defense of your territories, but not for just mere fighting of the people. On the contrary, peace, peace, peace is the primary objective of Islam. And I'm sure also it is so for the other holy religions, because all the holy religions, they work for the benefit of humanity.
Yes. Dr. Surur, how do you see the importance of such conferences in showing the good side and the truth about Islam being the religion of forgiveness, tolerance, and peace?
Well, I think this is a very important landmark. We have to remember all the efforts which have been done before, the conferences which Al-Azhar held before under the chairmanship of His Excellency the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar and His Excellency the Pope of the Vatican, in addition to the leaders of other faiths from all over the world. And now this conference is being held with leaders of Islamic religion from the various countries. We got to speak to each other. We got to take the message which come out of such meeting to the policymakers, and let us apply it on ground. Because unless we take this message and this conclusion of such important meeting to reality, then actually it becomes a waste of time. You know, we have to come into action. You know, I'm very sorry to say that even with so many meetings have been arranged before, but when you come to the reality, then you find people go into conflicts and sufferings because of the mere difference in the faith. And we have examples, of course, of this, several examples, what happened in Europe, what happened in Asia, and what's been happening in the Middle East. All this just tells us an example that though we have been talking about it, and though we have been holding conferences and meetings about it, still, you know, the responsible people, the policymakers, the governments, and the population at large got to be aware of this issue and got to realize the importance of this issue in order to be effective and in order to reach our common goal.
Yes, I thank you very much for your time, Professor Dr. Gamal Abu Surur, Director of Islamic Center for Population Studies, Al Azhar University. Thank you very much for joining us over the phone. Ladies and gentlemen, a short break, and I'm going to be back with you.